To the Lord. wisdom be attentive.
In the depth of your wisdom, O Lord. tidings of faith also. Why then did you put God to the test by trying to place on the shoulders of these converts a yoke which neither we nor our fathers were able to bear? Our meaning is rather that we are saved by the Savior of the Lord Jesus, and so are they. And that the whole assembly fell silent. They listened to Barnabas and Paul as the two described all the signs and wonders God had worked among the Gentiles through them.
Peace be to your wisdom, be attentive.
King Antioch
a diaphanous thing of the Seleucid Empire, decided just to know what kind of empire, what is that supposed to mean. After Alexander the Great died, his empire was divided between Diadochi, or Diadochi, his successors, military leaders, and of course all that empire was of Greek culture, meaning also Greek religion. So one of those successors that the new empire arose, Seleucid Empire, and at some point this king decided to wipe out that Jewish religion and to plant the seed to force them to worship Greek gods and to accept Greek culture, Greek religion. So there was he forbade Jews to circumcise their children, their sons, to that degree that mothers that circumcised their sons were crucified with their historians say that mothers were crucified with their children around their necks. So they were forcing them to abandon their religion. It was forbidden to have a copy of the law, family or household. It was forbidden for them to have a copy of the law. It's for us, it's the same as to have a copy of Bible, for Bible at home. And then we know what happened, a revolt by Judas Maccabeus and his supporters. He was the son of a priest, and he was a priest himself. And we know that war was lasting for about, since 167 to 160 before Christ. Even though they lost, but since the revolt was lasting for so long, they eventually gained some freedoms, and they freed Jerusalem in some degree. So they cleansed the temple, they cleansed the Jerusalem of all the idols and all the, because they built in the old Holy of Holies. In the center of the temple, they made out of from the altar of God. They were bringing offerings. Jews were bringing offerings to God on their altars. Greeks made an altar to Zeus. So they had to cleanse it and rededicate it to God. So that's what Jews were celebrating here today in the gospel. So we, and that's what, somehow that's, today it falls in maybe a coincidence, or that's how church decided to put it together, to combine, so these, the this part of the gospel matches the epistle. Because what takes, what's happening in the, what we heard in the epistle, first church council. Main decision was, main question to be, to find an answer, to make a decision, was should Gentiles, new Christians, because first Christians were from the Jews, and they of course were holding the law of Moses, mainly the law, a requirement of circumcision, and all of their feasts, fasting, everything that was according to their tradition, their religion. So should Gentiles adopt those, their traditions and their rules? And that's what they had to find, to figure out. And it was decided that no, because now not circumcision of Moses unites them. They shouldn't become Jews. They are Christians now. They are followers of Christ. Christ is uniting them together, which supposed to teach us that now the chosen nation of God is us Christians, is the church, not some one single nation. Despite the differences that we have of different race, of different nations, citizenship, language, traditions, rites, rituals, our understanding of religion, our understanding of faith. Now, if we work for Christ, we are together, all of us are Christians. And it doesn't matter how hard we fought centuries or thousands of years ago to keep our traditions. Imagine the Jews, the first Christians out of the Jews, and they fought so hard to keep their religion, their traditions, and now they have to allow new Christians, Gentiles, not to hold their traditions. And that's a lesson for us. No matter how different we are, we should understand each other and accept each other because Christ accepts us despite our differences. Christ is risen.
Indeed, Jesus.
Let us all sing with our whole soul and with our whole mind. Let us sing.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, have mercy. God of our fathers, we pray here and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray here and have mercy. Fathers and from our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our government and for all in the service of our country.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the people who are present and waiting. Also show us mercy and all Christians of the true faith.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, loving God, and give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, bring your and mercy.
Thank you.
Church, King, our Holy Father, Francis, Pope of Rome, our old Travers, and the Apostle, Wheeler, God loving, Bishop Kurt, the entire priest of the Ecclesiastic Order, our guardians and all in the service of our country, the eternal fathers and benefactors of this Holy Church. May Lord God remember all you Christians of the true faith, always, now, and ever, and forever. Ever existing and ever the same.
You and your only begotten Son, the Holy Spirit, who burst out of an existence into being, yet again raise us up when we have fallen, left nothing undone until you brought us to heaven and gave us a kingdom to come. For all this we thank you, your only begotten Son, your Holy Spirit, for all that we know and that we do not know, for the manifest and hidden benefits bestowed on us. We also thank you for this liturgy which you have pleased to accept from our hands, even though there stand before you thousands of archangels, tens of thousands of angels, cherubim and seraphim, six winged and many eyes soaring aloft on their wings. Singing, shouting, crying aloud, and sing a triumphal hymn.
Thank you.
grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
As we stand in the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another in the whole life of Christ our God.
Through you,
and make us worthy of measure that we weigh with confidence without condemnation, or call you Father, God of heaven and earth.
May the partition of your holy mysteries, O Lord, be
Virgin Mary, and of all your saints, make straight our path, and firm us all in fear of you, guard our life, and safeguard our steps. For your sanctification, we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. By divine power, do not forsake us, hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the priest, our government, and to all your people. For all generous giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, and we give glory, thanksgiving, and worship to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Risen.